Welcome to Electronegativity and Bond Character, in which we will explore how we can use electronegativity to determine whether a bond is nonpolar covalent, polar covalent, or ionic, otherwise known as bond character or bond type. Electronegativity is defined as the tendency of an atom to attract a shared pair of electrons. It is a value without a unit, just a number that each element has, derived empirically from a low of 0.7 to a high of 4.0. Lower numbers indicate less attraction for shared electrons, and higher numbers indicate more attraction for shared electrons. Across the periodic table, electronegativity values increase from bottom to top and from left to right. But it is the electronegativity difference between two bonded atoms that give us bond character or bond type, with smaller electronegativity difference being more covalent, meaning shared bonding electrons, versus higher electronegativity difference being more ionic, which is a transfer of electrons between bonded atoms. It is a continuum of bond character, changing from covalent at one end to ionic at the other. We will look at all that in detail starting now. The divisions on the continuum are generally from 0 to 0.4 being nonpolar covalent, meaning the electron sharing is equal between atoms. From 0.4 to 1.7 is considered polar covalent, meaning an unequal sharing, and greater than 1.7 is considered ionic, meaning a transfer of electrons. These divisions are somewhat arbitrary, and this will be considered in more detail toward the end of the video. In a covalent bond, bonded atoms overlap because the electrons are shared, and so we show the shared electrons as being in the middle. Where the shared electrons are can change depending on electronegativity difference, and so let's shrink the atoms to focus on how the electrons are being shared, which will clarify the meaning of the different bond types. And we will also use the element symbols because each element has a specific electronegativity. Since these are both chlorine atoms, they have the same electronegativity, being 3.0, and so the electronegativity difference is 0, 3 minus 3. Each atom is attracting the shared electrons equally, and so we call this a nonpolar covalent bond, meaning an equal sharing of bonding electrons. Let's see how bonding different elements changes how electrons are shared. With hydrogen bonded to chlorine, the electronegativity difference is 0.8, a polar bond. Chlorine has a higher electronegativity than hydrogen, and remember that electronegativity is how well an atom attracts a shared pair of electrons. So a higher electronegativity is better at attracting shared electrons than a lower electronegativity. The word polar refers to this polarity, the unequal sharing of electrons. The chlorine acquires a partially negative character due to the shared electrons spending more time at the chlorine, and the hydrogen therefore acquires a partially positive charge. The Greek letter delta tells us it is a partial charge, and so we say the hydrogen is delta plus, the chlorine is delta minus. And this is a result of the unequal sharing of bonding electrons, which spend more time at the chlorine, making it more negative and the hydrogen more positive. And all of this is also shown by the electronegativity difference of 0.8, which is 3 minus 2.2, indicating a polar bond. Let's look at an even larger electronegativity difference, here between sodium and chlorine. Sodium has an electronegativity of 0.9, and so the difference is 2.1, meaning rather than a sharing of electrons, sodium has transferred its valence electron to chlorine, which creates an ionic bond, a transfer of electrons. This creates a full positive charge on the sodium and a full negative charge on the chlorine. It is the electronegativity difference between two bonded atoms that determines whether the bond is nonpolar, polar, or ionic. But this is very much a continuum in which the difference in charge gets larger going from left to right. However, we need to consider that only in a molecule consisting of two atoms would the bond character be the same as the molecule's character. And there are extremely few diatomic molecules. In all molecules with more than two atoms, a variety of factors, including bond polarity, has to be considered to determine the character of the entire molecule in being nonpolar or polar, which is addressed in the video linked here, How to Determine the Polarity of a Molecule. Lastly, let's address where the nonpolar, polar, and ionic cutoffs come from. This graph gives us the amount of electron transfer occurring as percent ionic character, from 0% being electrons shared equally to 100% being a complete transfer of electrons. So from this graph, one can assume that the moment you no longer have a 0%, the bond is polar. While this is correct, it is not until approximately 0.4 electronegativity difference that polarity begins to appear as a macro property, and so 0.4 became the cutoff between nonpolar and polar. The 1.7 cutoff is more arbitrary. It is simply where the graph gives 50% ionic character. The point again is how the molecule manifests properties at the macro level, and in general, as one gets above 1.7 electronegativity difference, more ionic properties tend to appear at the macro level. It is not possible, however, to get to 100% ionic, which is a complete electron transfer, because the resulting positive ion will always momentarily attract electrons back to it due to opposite charge, and so there is always a small amount of electron sharing in any ionic bond. This has been a Mad Scientist production. See ya!